Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to talk about a huge change that's coming to Adobe programs in March, and that's that they are not going to offer Pantone color libraries inside the software anymore. So Pantone basically just won't be supported by Adobe anymore. Now, this probably sounds pretty crazy because as graphic designers, we use Pantone colors at least every once in a while, if not every day. The reason for this change, according to Pantone, is that Adobe wasn't updating the software with the newest Pantone colors. And my guess is that it probably costs Adobe a lot of money to pay Pantone for those latest colors. Whatever the reason, we're basically not going to have access to Pantone colors inside the Adobe programs, so I'm going to show you a few workarounds for this. All right, let's get started. First is the Pantone Connect extension. So I'm just gonna Google this, and I'll also put the link below in the description. So we can click on this down here at adobe.com. Now, Pantone Connect comes with a free version and a paid version. And I've already installed this extension, but if you haven't, you'll see a free button. So click that, and then it'll ask you to connect to Creative Cloud. You'll probably need to close Photoshop, Illustrator, and InDesign, and it'll prompt you for that. Then you can hit Install and click OK. So now I'm gonna get into Illustrator, and we'll come up here to Window, Extensions, and here is Pantone Connect. Now, as I mentioned before, unfortunately, this is a paid extension, and it's $7.99 a month. But I'm just going to show you how this works, and then I'll show you a way to use the free version. So I'm going to click Create New. I'm just going to come up here to Print, Letter, and we'll create. It looks like I'll need to get my extension back up once I do that. So there are four tabs right down here at the bottom. We can't really use my palettes without paying. If I scroll down and try to create a palette, it'll switch me over to the Colors tab and pick, and then if I try to choose one, we're going to get the paywall. And I'll just click Go Back to Free. But we can do colors and then pick. Up here at the top, you can choose which color book you want to use. I'm going to go with this formula guide coded. So all of these are spot colors on coded stock. We can change our chip size to small, which is the way I like to use it. And then we can go through and pick a color we want to use. Now, if we click on this, we're going to get right back to that paywall. So we can't actually sample that color. Now, when I first logged in here, I was able to do one color and one color only. So when I clicked this, it came up right over here as my fill color, but I think it only lets you do one and then it wants you to pay after that. So anyway, my workaround here is just to screenshot this. So on a Mac, that's Shift, Control, Command, and 4. And then we can just draw around that. And what this does is it copies this area. Then I can come over here and just paste it with Command V. If you have a Windows machine, for Windows 10 and newer, you can press the Shift, the Windows key, and S. And all the options for screen grabs comes up on the top of your screen. And one of them is select a region. Once you're done selecting the region, it'll copy it to the clipboard and you can just paste it like we did here. Or you can click the notification to open what you grabbed and save it as a file. So now that we have our Pantone color on the artboard, I'll hit I to get my eyedropper right over here. And I'm going to click on the color. Unfortunately, when we use the color picker, we don't get the actual Pantone color values here, but what's on your screen, this color, is just going to be a representation anyway. Everybody's screen is going to show that color a little differently. A printer needs to actually match this to a printed out Pantone book. I actually have another video about how Pantone colors work, and that should be at the top of your screen right now if you want to check it out. Then I'll bring up my swatches panel. And if you're not seeing that, it'll be right under here, under Window, Swatches, right down here. So now that we have it as a fill, we can create a new swatch. When I do this, I make sure it's a spot color, and then I name it by the Pantone color. So we'll just do that. And then we'll say okay. So here is our new swatch right here. So as you probably noticed, that takes a long time, especially if you're dealing with a lot of different colors. So because most of the colors are already available in Illustrator libraries in CC 2021 and 2022, I'm just going to make my own Pantone swatch libraries from the color books. So I'm going to show you how to do that. We'll get out of Pantone Connect. And the reason I'm doing this is because I assume that in March, our Swatch libraries and our color books are going to go away completely. So I'm going to save my own Swatch library that will travel with my computer. So to do that, I've got my Swatches up and I'm going to click on the flyout and choose Open Swatch Library, Color Books. And then the one that I use the most is Pantone Solid Coated. So I'm going to open that one. And this gives us all the colors in Pantone Solid Coated. Then I'm going to remove all the swatches in my swatch list. So I've clicked on the first one, I'll hold shift and click on the last one and just delete those. It'll ask me if I want to delete and I'll say yes. Now I'm going to do the same thing, except I'm going to add all the swatches from this book to my swatch library. So I'm going to click on the first one. I'll scroll all the way to the bottom, hold shift and click on the last one. Then I'll come up here to the little flyout and choose add to swatches. Now this is a lot of swatches and it might slow your computer down a little bit, but the end result is that we get all of these from the color book into our swatch panel. And then the next step is to just save this as the same thing. So I'm going to come over here to the flyout and choose save swatch library as ASE. And it's going to ask me where I want to put this. It automatically saves it onto my computer. So on a Mac, this is going to be something like your home and then library, application support, Adobe, Adobe Illustrator 25, ENUS, and then swatches. So I'm going to go ahead and rename this to Pantone Plus Solid Coated. And I'll just save that here. It's going to tell me about gradients, patterns, and tints. I'm not too worried about that because doing it this way is better than nothing. So we'll say okay. Now the location on a Windows machine is going to be similar, but you might have to Google where your swatches are kept if it doesn't automatically go to the right place. Then you can go ahead and repeat that process for all of the other color books in Illustrator right now. Then after March comes and goes and your swatches don't have the color books loaded anymore, you can still come down here to Open Swatch Library, choose User Defined, and you'll see those swatch libraries that you created still right down here. So that takes care of all the older colors. With the newer colors, you can just use the process I showed before with the Pantone Connect extension. Or, you know, you can pay the $7 a month for the Pantone Connect premium extension, which is probably pretty similar to what we have access to now. For me, that just doesn't make sense, but hey, you do you. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.